Man, doesn't that look good? All right. Let's see here. Howdy, folks. I'm glad to be here. Hope you are too. And I wanted to talk to you about, how many people. I got this question, and I get it sometimes. I usually just answer it for them, and I figured, man, I'm getting enough of this question. I need to do a little video. So I'm going to do a little video, and let's see how little I can keep this, right? So I want to say hey to everybody. I do want to, this was so cool to me. I want to show this. This is Action Jackson. Says, Muddy Moses eats and treats at the ball field in Twin Falls, Idaho. Next time I'm in Idaho, I'm going there. I was there a couple of years ago in Boise and loved Idaho. That's a beautiful place. I'm slinging some good eats and tasty treats. Thanks, Ben. I owe it to you. Vending gave me my life back. I responded to him and said, Action Jackson, you made my day. Thank you for that. But the facts are, you made it happen. Because he did. He made this happen and did the work. Not me. He did the work. And he owns the success. So the success belongs to you. You did it. But I appreciate the kind words, and I'm glad I could be a little piece of the pie. I appreciate it though. Survival Man, welcome. First time catching us live. Glad you're here. We probably all need to be over on your channel soon. If this coronavirus gets even worse, we'll be all looking for ways to survive, right? So anyway, when you start vending, you come up with all these questions, and it is normal because at first, you're like, how hard could this be? I'm going to boil a hot dog, stick it on a bun, put the condiments on it, hand it to a customer for $3 or $4 or $5. And then I'm going to have that money. And my biggest problem is, what am I going to do with all this money, right? And then it starts and you go, and the closer you get to it, you come up with more questions and more questions. And you're like, oh my gosh, I need to, said you can't hear me. Hopefully you can hear me now. Can you hear me now? Anyway. You're like, oh my gosh, I don't know what to do. So one of the questions that's come up a lot is how many people, let's say there's 10 people that come by, how many are those going to eat with me? Well, this kind of questions, it's kind of like, a bagel and a bucket of grits, just doesn't know what to do with itself. Because it's one of those deals where there's so many variables and you're going, well, Ben, that's not a good answer. And Ben, I want you to tell me something like three. Well, I can't. And here's why I can't, because I need more information. Okay? Because let me give you an example. I'm going to just give you just an obvious one that everybody's going to understand this example. You're outside of an all-you-can-eat buffet set up, and the buffet is free. Well, you're going to have a lot of people coming by your cart, right? But how many out of 10 are going to eat? Altogether, total, none, right? Because it's free inside, it's a buffet. So those are variables. Now that was a ridiculous one, but there's other variables because where are they headed? What time of day it is matters a lot. That's why a lot of people go, well, what do I do about a bathroom, Ben? I'm out there on the street. What do people do for potty breaks? Well, you train your body, number one, to not need to during that time. There are cases of emergency. I've had one, but you're typically out there for 2 to 3 hours. That's it. So, not a hard one to surpass, just don't drink 6 cups of coffee before you go. So these questions though are normal and common and it makes sense, but I need to know where you are. I need to know about the location. I need to know, let me give you an example. You're in front of a Tractor Supply and you're there on Saturdays because Saturdays is a great day for Tractor Supply, by the way, it is. And you're there from 11 to 2, okay? And they have 100 customers between 11 to 2. That would be a slow Tractor Supply, but let's just say that, okay? So 100 customers. Are they all going to need food? No, we don't know how many of them ate before they got there. How many came at 12:35 because they just stopped at Hardee's at 12? So we don't know the true number. So the best thing I can tell you is to one, test, two, find out what their busiest day is. Talk to the manager. Go, what's y'all's busiest day? I bet y'all are busy a lot. What's your busiest day? You don't have to go, I want to be here just on your busy day. What is the busy day? Don't do it like that. Say to them, hey, y'all are a busy store. I didn't realize how busy it is here. What seems to be your busiest day? You can word it in a way that doesn't look like you're prying for information, security information. So once you get that information, order, give him lunch, and then ask you, right? Then or her. Ask the manager, and then go check it. Maybe park in the parking lot from 12 to 1. Put you an audio book on so you're not bored to tears. And count the people that walk in and get an idea. And you're going, well, that's a pain in the neck. But it's only one time. You only do it once. You don't do this every day. I'm going to be out there counting and listening to my audio books. No, you just do it once and you try it. Or you just go out on a limb and go do it. And you go, you know what? Tuesdays suck around here. I mean, there wasn't 12 people that walked in between 12 and 1. What a waste of time. Only two of them bought. There isn't an average. There's not an average. There's vendors set up in locations. Let me give you an example. There's a vendor in East Tennessee. He's set up at a pool of parts. You go in there with your wrenches and stuff to all these old cars, and then you take them off the parts that you need, and you come out through the gate, you pay for the part, and you leave. Some people call it you pull it, pick a part. There's a blue million names. But anyway, he sets up there, right? What day does he set up there? Saturday and Sunday. Why? Because they're busier than crap. People work through the week, and then Saturday and Sunday, I'm going to fix Mamaw's car. So I'm going to go get a new starter and a new windshield wiper motor. And they go out there and do that. Well, how many of those people eat? Almost all of them. I mean, it's astronomical, the numbers. Most all of them. Most of them got there before it got real hot in the day. And by the time they're leaving, it's lunchtime. And what better place to eat than right now, right here, today? I ain't driving to McDonald's and waiting in line for the same old crap I ate for the last 6 weeks. So that's the difference. So it really depends on where you are in the setup. There's people like Frankenstein. Y'all have seen me there many times. He's set up in front of an O'Reilly's. He's not getting walk-in traffic, even from O'Reilly's. His traffic is people pulling off the road because it's a congested area. It's easy to get in and out. The max speed limit's 12 or something there. And so it's very easy to get in and out. He's in a huge parking area next to the auto parts. So it's easy for people to get in and out of the traffic. It just is, it's simple. He gets all his business from that traffic. So how many cars go by before he gets a customer? I don't even think he knows the answer to that, because typically we don't encourage trying to stop traffic. We want walking traffic. So that's the answer in a nutshell. We could go deeper in it, and you could give me a specific place, and I could probably narrow it down closer to some kind of figure, but it still have variables. Because have you noticed at a location, you can be there on the third week, let me put it this way, on the second week of the month and do crappy, okay? And then the fourth week of the month, you're kicking butt. The first week of the month, you're kicking butt. And you're going, why? Why? And if you're keeping good records like I teach, and I make it simple, a yellow pad, truly a yellow pad to keep your records. You don't need no fancy software, right? And you can narrow it down and go, I've got to notice something. The 1st through the 3rd of each month and the 26th through the 30th of each month, I kick butt. Why is that be? Because people tend to spend more when they know the bills are paid and right when they got paid. That's how that works. It's why Fridays work real good at places, because Friday's typically payday in America and people spend and reward themselves. Even though it's a small reward, we all do it. My wife last night goes, let's splurge and get a pizza. And I went, woo, let's do. How exciting. Are we going to have candles? So the point is that it's not a have to know those figures. If you follow my information on locations, and if you need help there, go to learnhotdogs.com. Then type in the word location in the search box. You're going to be inundated with information, overload. Okay? Just pick out a couple of the articles I've done and go, okay, I'm going to follow this. I'm going to write some notes, and then I'm going to do it. Because if you'll apply those things, you will never, ever lack from customers. So you don't really have to know that. Okay, now I've narrowed this down. I need to know if there's 2 7/8 people on average that are going to buy for every 12 customers that walk by, or potential customers. So 2 7/8, you don't need all that math, okay? I don't even know how to do 2 7/8. I can't do fractions with my toes, okay? It hurts. Anyway, that was it for me. So I'm going to go through here. If you have a question, I'll try to get it answered. Thanks, Kay Teeble says, it is hearing me fine, hearing me fine. Vance Bridges, first time here. Thanks for being here, Vance. Glad you're here. Hello from New York, Mike Zoma. Dennis and Susan in the house. Glad to see you. Brian Pierce, hello from Classic Kettle Corn. Classic Kettle Corn. I've got a Kettle Corn interview to do tomorrow. It is fantastic. I'm excited. For the reason I'm excited is because this guy has sent me about 7 or 8 emails with all kinds of pictures and stuff. Started out with nothing and now has, I believe, 5 Kettle Corn vans and trucks and holy moly. Wait till you hear from him. Let's see, David Gregory in the house. Thanks for being here, David. I'm looking for questions. First time live, long time listener. Back in the day that Corey was at the beach, didn't you guys call him Flipper? That was not Corey, but Corey was part of that conversation, so you're kind of right. That was Brian Shores at the beach, New Jersey Shores, okay? And we did call him Flipper because he flipped his freaking cart over, right? He bought a cart from another company, and they make them tall and skinny because they plan on people not using them, and it flips over very easy. And all he did is he didn't even round the corner hard. He just barely hit the curb, and it went. Smitty. Let's see. Greetings from Texas, Jack Gordon. I'm glad you're here from Texas. Tammy Key's in the house. Sasha Gabriel's in the house. Thanks for being here. Let's see. I'm going to read this. Tash, I have to say I've really enjoyed learning from you, Ben. I am trying to get started. Just got the book, Hot Dog Saved My Life, and Lemonade Pro, reading as fast as I can. Awesome. Let me tell you something. You are going to freaking love this business. If you love people, you're self-motivated, like nobody's got to wake you up in the morning and make you go to work kind of deal, like you just want to do stuff. You've seen real, real successful people. They don't lay around on yachts. I mean, they may have a vacation, but what I'm saying is they're always looking for more. I've got a buddy in this business that probably could quit, really. He could probably just let it run. And he continues on. He's continuing on. He keeps doing something different because that's how entrepreneurs are. We're like, okay, I made it. There is no – last night in the Vendors United meeting, I'm not changing subjects. Vendors United meeting, we're in there, and Don Marler, y'all got to watch part of his video, one of his videos I did a couple weeks ago. He's the Daddy-O Cheesesteaks, right? Well, Don's in our group, and Don goes I lost my train of thought. Hold on, I'm thinking. I'm reading this question to see if I can get back to where I started. I can't remember. Bottom line is if you do start off and don't try to be everything to everybody, just find your niche and do it. Okay. Don brought up something about this in the meeting, and I just lost my train of thought. Look at there, Steve V in the house. They do good. They're in the colder climates of Minnesota. And work through the winter. Work through the winter. This is his second winter. Him and Amy have worked through the winter, and I'm talking brutal cold. They're in the VU group, and he sent pictures to us and videos where it is just brutally cold, and you're going, how does he do it? Well, the money seems to keep you warm. Back to Tash though, I lost a little bit of that because the scroll bar kept going, but. You're going to love this business. So if you're motivated and you'll get out there and do it, you'll end up being successful, period. Okay. If you will go to me personally right now today, I tell you at this time of year, I jump on the lemonade bandwagon instantly, low cost to get in, and you can make money quick. Okay. I'm talking first weekend quick. First day pay for everything you bought. It is that good. So what I would do is go to, you've already been, but anybody else that's listening that wants to, howtostartalemonadebusiness.com. How to start a lemonade business. It's right there on the bottom. Check that out. Let's see. This thing went nuts. It started going up. Okay. Mini Life says, hey, Ben, I need more hot dog vendor radio. You know, we were doing just radio. I wasn't doing really YouTube except sporadically, you know, a video every 6 months. And then I wouldn't have Facebook. We weren't doing no Facebook lives because they didn't even have live back then. And so we did a lot of years of broadcasting on iTunes and Blog Talk Radio, Spreaker, Stitcher, all of them. And they're still there. They're still available. And all the information, it's not like the information goes bad. Okay. Back to the question. It's almost a time thing. It's a time restraint. But I love doing it. I could probably take the audio from these and turn it into a blog, a podcast, but it wouldn't be as fun. I don't know if you can hear this. These are some of the commercials we used to play. You have to tell me if you can hear this. I don't know if that played. Did you hear that? Hopefully you heard it. If not, I apologize for wasting your time. That was one of the commercials from Hot Dog Vendor Radio. And you can still go to hotdogvendorradio.com, but it's going to take you, I think, to here, to the YouTube page. Anyway, there was something else. So I would start with lemonade vending. And get that course and then go and let it buy your hot dog cart. Okay. If you want to see how that's done in real life, go to learnhotdogs.com/lemon. And I outline exactly how to do that so that you let the lemonade pay for your hot dog cart, but in the right way so that you don't end up overspending, overdoing, thinking you got to have 16 carts to start off with and all that crap. It is a wonderful feeling when you get started and you're making real money to be putting some money back for the rainy days, because even the best of us have rainy days. Back to the original question, though, about number of people. One of the things I wanted to, I guess, a good analogy would be as if you came to me and said, or I came to you and said, hey, what's the best color I should paint my house? Or what type of paint should I use to paint my house? You'd go, well, I can't answer that without knowing some other information. Because it'd just be a guess, right? Well, that's kind of like this question about how many people out of 10 people that walk by am I going to get? Well, it depends. Put free, you'll get 10 or 9 at least, right? Let's see. Business comes and goes and ebbs and flows was exactly the same when I was set up to sell vegetables. Absolutely, David Gregory. It does ebb and flow. But I can tell you this. Last night, I don't know if this had anything to do with what I was going to tell you earlier, but Don Marler, again, cheesesteak guy, Daddy-O's, he talked about this, that he could turn off by doing his posts on Facebook, he could make a day really, really busy if he was trying to make 12 grand in a week. Or make it slow, where he can just chill a little bit and still serve a bunch. You should see his lines. You should see the people that complained when he said he's going on a vacation. He's leaving for, I believe, 10 days. And people are like, oh, my gosh, his posts are getting shared. His bad news gets shared like people's good news. It's incredible the amount of follows and stuff he has built up, all because he serves a good product. He's friendly. He's happy. And if you haven't watched his interview, watch it. It'll change. It'll make you happy. Holy cow. I don't know if YouTube saves these for me or what until there's 25 comments and then it sends them all to me at once. Should you work a spot for more than 3 days? It depends on the spot because it depends on the customer. Some, like, some places have the same customers every day, okay? Some, but most places don't. I ain't at Tractor Supply every day. So if you're there every day, I'm probably going to see you once every couple of weeks. I ain't going to see you every day. So every day, time I see you, it will be a treat. So it depends on the kind of place it is. Now, if I was going to the hospital, okay, not because something was wrong with me, because I found out my local hospital, we just had a vendor do this again. We've had some incredible stories about the hospitals. Okay, they shut down the cafeterias about 4 p.m. They ain't open the rest of the day until the next morning. Well, people are all into the, you know, Wheel of Death vending machines, and that's all they can get. And the doctors, nurses, and stuff, they are ordering in, take out, whatever else, but they're sick of the same old crap. Well, if you go and you work it one day a week, you will do phenomenal. You try to work it 4 days a week, you probably won't do so good because the same nurses and doctors and all are there. They don't want to eat hot dogs 4 days a week. So what they will do, it's kind of like when I was doing the factory gig with my wife, we started out every night of the week and quickly learned out people won't eat it every night. So we actually made more just by going to 2 days a week. We started doing 2 days a week and it was killing, kicking butt, but it was the same people. See, but if it's not the same people, like you're hitting a different shift every night between 11 and one, it's a different crew of employees, then have at it. 7 days a week is great, but not if it's not. I hope that makes sense. Tom Nicky's Prairie Dogs in the house. Glad you're here, Dave Gregory. Someday, I already read that one. Don't want you live paycheck to paycheck anymore. I want to be blessed like you, man. Live paycheck to paycheck. I get you. Yeah, nobody likes paycheck to paycheck. I hate it. Stink, sucks. Your best bet to avoid paycheck to paycheck. If you are my dearest family friend, my loved one. And I do love you either way, but what I'm saying is if because a lot of people go, what would you tell your mom to do or your sister to do or your daughter to do? Well, my daughter, I've got seven daughters and one just started vending. Just started. In fact, she starts on the 14th. Sorry. But she just got all her licensing and permit in Oregon. So, and she's an adult. She's got a degree. She teaches school, but she is sick of paycheck to paycheck. And she's my first one to go into vending, other than when they were kids. She's one of those ones. She was one of the daughters that made the $1,407 in one day at the flea market. Her and my daughter Nina, they made $1,407 in one day at the flea market. And they didn't want to work ever again because they thought they had hit the lottery. They were rich. We don't need to work anymore. Because I was immediately, wait till tomorrow. We'll see what you do tomorrow. We don't want to work tomorrow. We don't need to work anymore, Dad. So anyway, living paycheck to paycheck, back to that. No matter who you are, I'd give you the honest truth. And I'd say start on a shoestring budget, even if you got $5,000 on your credit card that you can spend today. Start on a shoestring budget so that you can get in the black quickly, okay? And then let the business pay for your upgrades and then write it all off on taxes because you can write off your new. You know, we got lemonsmasherstore.com. It's this fancy freaking lemon smasher that's lifetime warranty. Lifetime. Okay. But you don't have to buy that up front. You can buy the hand smasher. In fact, I suggest it in my course. So I don't make anything because I don't sell hand smashers. You can get one on Amazon. So you don't need me to sell you one. I'm just telling you the truth. If you want to make money quick, then start with lemonade, and especially this time of year. Now, if it was December and we're coming into the heart of winter, I'd say no. Lemonade, even though we've got vendors that vend it year-round, like Corey Lawrence, he's in Missouri and he vends it year-round. We've got people like, I believe, Steve or Amy. I think they have lemonade year-round. They pay more for their lemons and stuff right now. But they're still making plenty of profit. But the point is, if you were starting then, I'd say go with hot dogs. Start off with hot dogs. That'd be quick and easy, and everybody will like a good, hot, hearty meal. But if you want to start on shoestring budget this time of year, I'd tell you lemonade, lemonade, lemonade. So when my sisters called me and needed help a couple years ago, I said lemonade. I didn't say, you're going to need to buy you a big dog cart, and you're going to need to get these fancy signs, and you're going to need to buy all this stuff from me. I said, nope. We can start this for under $500. and you can probably pay it off in the first day. Pay yourself back. And so they did, and they did. Their first day, I believe, was a Friday, and it's called Art on the Green or something, or Town on the Green or something. It's up in the North Carolina mountains. It's a small gathering, but they made over $500 and profit. They paid themselves back for everything. And so it just blossomed from there. So the point is, it's my own sisters. I told them Lemonade. So you go to that link down below, Lemonade Vending, right there, how to start a lemonade business.com, and you will be hooked up. Thursday sales could be good for vendors that can take cards. Absolutely. A good point, Jay. You should be taking cards any time, because nowadays, 10 years ago when I was doing YouTube, I was telling you, man, it's a cash business, all cash, cash, cash. And it still is for some. Still is a lot of cash. Even for the ones taking cards, it's still about 50-50, 60-40 split cards to cash. But if you're not taking cards, you're going to lose money. You're going to lose money. It's like leaving money on the table. It's like going, going and cashing your check at the bank, and the bank lays it all out there, counts it for you, and sets it on the counter in front of you, and you take half of it and walk off. Who would do that, right? Take cards. People go, well, Ben, the cards charge fees. So what? So what? What are you going to pay? Three cents on a dollar? Who cares? Now that goes to what my friend Jason Brown says. You're stepping over dollars to pick up dimes. Let's see. The wife asked me if I had a hot date. I said Ben would be laughing. Rick, that's funny. I like that there. Hey, first time out this weekend. We'll have Biz Roll King. Any last minute advice to calm the first time jitters? Actually, Polly, first time jitters. Guess what? Here's some calming information for first-time jitters, and then I got to go. It's almost 9:30. Good, great. Okay, so here's what I do to – what I advise to do and what I advise for you to remember, okay? Nobody knows, if you haven't been vending for 150 years, that you're the 17th in generation of vending. And that the way you do it isn't the exact right way to do it. Okay? Nobody knows. So if you put condiments on first and the hot dog on second, nobody's going to go, that's not how you do that. Say, that's how us pro vendors do it. My mama and papa came over on the Mayflower, and they told me that's how they had been doing it. No, old man. It really doesn't matter. The other thing is everybody out there basically puts on their pants the same way as we do, one leg at a time. They ain't nothing different from them. Yes, I have been nervous because the mayor showed up to eat or something, or the sheriff showed up to eat. And I'm not talking about a deputy. I'm talking about the sheriff. And you're like, oh, man, I got to get that perfect. No, just be you. Always be perfect. Always do a good job. But don't worry. Mistakes and stuff, make light of it. Make a joke of it. Okay? I've had a hot dog drop on the floor and tell the line, hey, discount dogs right down here. It's our first one of the day. Who wants it? You know, that kind of thing. And just be funny. Throw it in the trash. Make sure everybody sees you throw it in the trash. Don't be like, I'll sneak this in the trash later. Don't like kick it under your cart, you know, because then it kind of grosses people out. There's, you know, food laying around. So pick it up with a glove, throw it away, take your gloves off, wash your hands, put on new gloves. Nobody's going to care the 15 seconds it takes to watch you do that. And they're going to be impressed. Don't worry about small mistakes. Grab the list on our site of checklists so you don't forget anything, maybe. That's one that worries people because you get all frantic and nervous and you forgot your hot dogs. My good friend, John Cavanaugh, did that his first day out. He got everything but the freaking hot dogs. So don't remember this. It just is. You're as human as everybody else. We're all human. This is fun. This is going to make you money. And if you could see it, what I see ahead of time, because I've watched me and I've watched other vendors, and now you know, you're looking back and you see a new vendor starting, you're going, oh my gosh, these people are going to kill it. They aren't going to believe it. If I told them where they'd be in 6 months, they'd probably just laugh me off the block, right? But it's the truth. If you just do these things, you're going to win. This isn't, well, some get lucky, some don't. We ain't playing the lottery. We ain't going to Vegas and playing craps or you know, whatever, shooting marbles. This is real, and it really works for 100% of the people that do these steps. There's no in between. There's no, well, I guess I just was unlucky and didn't make it. No, that's an excuse you could use if you wanted, but it means you probably didn't get off the couch. Them carts don't make a lot of money while you sit on the couch until you get them going and got people working. But another story, another day. Lone Star in the house, Jason Norwood. He's in our VU group. Jason Norwood, if you're wondering what I say about VU, vendorsunited.com, go check it out. Vendorsunited.com. The best vendors in the world. And you get help 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. And if vendors help sharing stuff that they wouldn't share anywhere else about the business and tips and tricks, like Don Marler just shared with everybody last night. Just craziness, okay? Craziness. High voltage karaoke, waiting for income tax, so I can get me one of your carts. Also, keep in mind, use carts or building a cart. If you're handy, you might just want to build one and save the money. I'd love to sell you a cart, but I'd rather sell you a cart, your second cart, than your first cart, and you were broke. I'd rather sell you second cart with profits from your first cart because you found a deal on Facebook Marketplace or something. So keep that in mind. I'm not saying I won't sell you one. I'm just telling you how I'd tell anybody to do the business. Hi, Ben, first time from Hot Dogs and More and Catering LLC in Virginia. Ed, thanks for being here, Ed. Glad you're here. Clearwater, Florida. Den Ken, 508. There, Sasha said it right there. Entrepreneurs are always doing something. Absolutely, Sasha. Adam, more power to you. I can't wait to hear about it. Please let me know. Just send me an email. Okay. BennettVendorsUnited.com. Just send me an email and tell me, or BennettLearnHotDogs.com. Tell me how you did. Okay. I'd like to hear good, bad, ugly. Tell me what you did, why you think you did it, how much you made if you want. I don't care if you share that, but as far as if you want to share it, I like hearing what people are doing, the real deal. Thursday sales can be, let's see, I already did that one. Oh, pie holes, gourmet snacks. I like that. Veronica in the house. Hey, y'all, Auburn, Alabama in the house. You know, one of my good friends, Mark Lawler, is in Alabama and does a good business there. He's got a Cater Pro and a Stand King and just kicks butt. And you can go spend a day with him for free. You can actually go there on us, go to Alabama and work it with him. Have a day of it. Learn what it's like from a cart in a small rural town in Alabama and go, if he can do it, if this bald-headed redneck dude can do this, I can do this. Don't be surprised when you get there and find out it's like 8'11" team, because he's super tall. But he's got a good heart, and he does it for us and part of our Vendors United group. We've got several vendors that do it. You can find that information at learnhotdogs.com/best-day-ever. Just put in /best-day-ever, and you'll go, oh my gosh, I can just pick a vendor. Yep, you pick a vendor, go spend it with them. And we even go above and beyond. If you later get a cart and you did that day with the vendor, we're going to take off $300 off your purchase of a cart if you buy a cart with us. Not that you have to buy a cart with us. It's just my way of saying, I like the way you think. I think you did your due diligence right by going and spending a day with a vendor, because what I found is that my customers who do their due diligence, whether it's spend a day with a vendor or watch the Day in the Life of a Vendor video series or any of that stuff, they're more successful every time. Those people are more successful right out of the gate. So, Thursday sales could be good for vendors. Let's see. I think I got them all, and I think it's what it stopped. It stopped scrolling. So anyway, I'm going to go. I love you. I hope that this, I know this went long, and I know that this has, I answered the questions up front quickly, but I always like when you come on here and you ask me questions, and because there's things I wouldn't have thought of to talk about. So I hope I helped you. For those that are just getting started and nervous day jitters, please email me and let me know how it went. I want to know. Okay, Ben@learnhotdogs.com. Send me an email and go, Ben, that was freaking awesome. Or Ben, that was the worst day ever. I'd have rather had three beatings than have to do that again. Tell me the truth. Tell me what's going on. Let me see if I can come up with a solution. Or do I need to get my pom-poms on and celebrate your day with you? Whatever it is. I think it's awesome. You're going to have fun. Here, YouTube's going to update now. I'm getting tons of them. Would it be a good idea to print off the schematics for the big dog cart and take them to the local health department? Just want to make sure I get what I need. Yes, Ryan, let me tell you exactly. If you go to learnhotdogs.com/, and these are all free. What I'm sending you to is free. learnhotdogs.com/start, the word start. So /start. I have step-by-step what you need to do. One of those steps is download the schematics from whatever cart you're getting and take it to your health department or email it to them. Some of them allow you to just email it to them. And that way it's done. And that way you already know you're pre-approved. It's not a guarantee. They'll tell you that because you get it there and they go, well, I didn't know that this thing was made out of cow poop and it's got cow poop smell to it. We can't allow you to serve from it. But in general, that's the reason you do this schematic pre-approval. In fact, I'm one of these manufacturers, the only one, that when you check out, it says, have you gotten your schematics pre-approved? Because I want to ensure that you've done your due diligence, because I don't sell carts just for the sake of selling freaking carts. I could sell lots more carts if I'd quit telling people all the pros and cons. Okay? I just sell carts. Give them all the good news and don't tell them none about the red tape and the bureaucracy and all the crap. And the fact that they actually have to get out and work and the cleaning a chili pan and what a pain in the neck that is. And I share that stuff because I want you to make a good decision. I don't sell carts for the sake of selling carts. I sell carts to watch you be successful because it boosts my ego. Okay, that's the main reason. So that you can fault me for. It does make me feel like $1 million when I hear y'all stories. That's the part that I love. Oh my gosh. Look at that. Nelson says, look at this. Nelson says, no Diet Pepsi 2 liter. Are you kidding me, Nelson? Are you kidding me? It's always beside me. Man, awesome videos, trying so bad to get in. The biz bought a used cart, but has problems. Travis, Carey, I have a solution for you. Okay. I should be posting this stuff up on here so that you don't have to remember this. LearnHotDogs.com. Just go to LearnHotDogs.com. Okay. Then in the search box, put repair. Just put repair. It's going to pull up, says how to repair your used hot dog cart. And I give you every step to do it cheap, even if you don't want to do it yourself, the way to get it done. Okay. So everything can be repaired on a cart. It can be repaired, replaced, fixed without spending a gob of money. So don't think, oh man, I had a guy just email me. He said he spent over $1,000, right at $1,000, to repair the burners and system on a used car he bought. And I was like, what? Holy moly. I don't know what kind of burner system you put in this, but if it's not powered by rocket fuel, you way overspent, because you can change out the whole entire gas system, including two brand new tanks, for less than $200. So maybe 300, max 300. So that's everything. Valves, switches, fuel rails, burners, valves, regulators, splitters for the regulators, tanks, and probably get them filled up too. That's just too much money. So the bottom line is check that out and then you won't have that issue. We just started in May 2019. We had a lemonade in July. And wow, the Smasher just prints money. Amen. A to the men. If you want to check that out, check out our Smasher. Go to, I'm going to put this in here, lemonsmasherstore.com. Okay. Hopefully that popped up. And then you can go there and check that out. I like that. Oh, Pie Hose is in Gourmet Snacks and Catering, Manchester, Tennessee. That's freaking awesome. Nephew, Charm and Chai, I've been doing everything you said, and I've been making great money and selling lobsters and shrimp. I can't wait to start doing my lemonade stand. Freaking awesome. Please send me freaking pictures, y'all. When you have something good news, send me a picture. Even if I don't write a story about it, I'll share it on Facebook because I like it. It makes me have a better day. So share. And it inspires others. People go, oh, there's actually people that are making this work. Well, yeah, we got thousands of them. But a lot of people think, oh, Ben's probably just hawking some book or something. And you know, a lot of people are leery, and I don't blame them. There's a blue million network marketing things going on and how to make money in the stock market. And this is all without gambling. You don't have to gamble. You can just do these things. Nephew, right here, will tell you so. Thank you for posting that up. Learning a lot from Hot Diggity Dog. Just got my wife with a lemonade stand. Javier Garcia, you are going to love, she's going to love the lemonade stand. She'll probably make more than you. It is phenomenal, the money you will make with a lemonade. It is the bomb. Hand pressed or the machine pressed, either way, do it in front of the customer and you will make a killing. Okay. I'm going to do a whole show and tell you how to get started on lemonade, the cheapest way, the links to get the stuff, where to find the stuff, the size of lemons to buy, where to buy the lemons, what type of sugar to use, how to make it all work. I'm going to provide all that for you soon. Okay. So I've got stuff coming. It's in my plans. Good luck to you, Javier. I know you don't need luck, but go get it and then share it. Tell me about it. Bill, hey, Ben, send me Florida commissary. I pay $350 a year plus $70 a month for water. Is this normal? I just sell dogs. It's expensive. I hate paying for a commissary. I tell people there's ways to do that without paying for a commissary. You've got vendors in and around you, okay, that ain't paying for their commissary. One of them being my sister, and they ain't paying for no commissary. There's a lot of vendors in Orlando, Kissimmee, all that area, and they ain't paying for commissaries. I would look at not paying for a commissary using my commissary stuff, and it's free. You don't pay me for nothing. You just go to learnhotdogs.com, type in the word commissary. You'll see the different methods for getting a commissary, and you go, oh, my gosh, I could have done that. Excuse me, and you could be saving $350 a year plus $70 a month. That's ridiculous. But I have to say this. I have friends who have saw the light and said, I can make money with a commissary. I'm going to build my own commissary, which saves me money. In fact, Michael Wood just is finishing up his own commissary. Okay, we've got a vendor in Asheville, North Carolina. He got out of vending completely and just has a commissary that he rents to other vendors. It's a money machine and commissaries. But there's so many ways to make money. There's so many ways to have a commissary without paying for it or paying way less. So keep that in mind. Look at that. But it is a good money-making thing, too. If you put in your own commissary or rent an old dilapidated kitchen and just get it certified for a commissary where it's not for public service, people ain't coming in and sitting down and eating at your restaurant. And I cover all this. Look it up, commissary on learnhotdogs.com. Still having problems wrapping my head around selling lemonade in anything other than summer months. David Gregory, I get you. You need to reach out. The ones I just told you about, Stever, Amy, Corey, these people, and there's more than that, but these people are doing lemonades year round. They're charged. Some don't. Some just quit because the lemonades get expensive in the winter, harder to get, less reliable service. You have to buy more than you need. That kind of stuff, it can be a pain, but they just raise the price. So if you're buying more for the widget that you're going to resell, you're just going to raise the price on the widget when you sell it. So that's what they're doing, and they're still successful with that. In the summer when, you know, right now lemons are starting to come in and from South America, and I don't know when California's come in. It'll be soon. And you'll start getting lemons, and you'll be like, oh, my gosh, it's a no-brainer. So you could start it really now, depending on where you live, March all the way through September, October, and have a safe time to do lemons, plenty of lemonades. video that North Carolina's released. I'm going to do that. Saw a video that North Carolina is released. Yeah, North Carolina is easy on certain things, and certain things they're not so easy. But I don't know what you're specifically referencing, but dang sure you can do funnel cakes easy in North Carolina. They don't even have a health permit for it. Kettle corn, super easy in North Carolina because it's agriculture. Okay. So let's see. I think lemonade's agriculture too in North Carolina. Anyway, we just started for the year and people are asking about lemonade already. Alan Anderson said, he also said this, lemonade equals money. It has unbelievable profit potential. And the beauty of lemonade, okay, is that it's such a small risk for a large profit. And I've got a friend that vends lemonade and he sells, I think it's two of the 32 ounce for $5, cheaper than anybody I know that does it. But he sells thousands every year, thousands. So is it doable? Yes. At $2.50 a lemonade, he's still making a killing. Okay. But most of the vendors, well, pretty much all the vendors in VU, they're $5, $6, $7 for a 32 ounce. That's about the range. $5, $6, $7 for a 32 ounce each. Anyway, I'm going to go. I love you. I wish you the best and I look forward to more. I'll be back soon. All right.